Mickey Allen.
AD.
This is the AD. This is Mickey Allen.
How you doing?
That's right.
Glad to have you home, bro.
At the White House, man.
You remember when you first started trying to get the team honored?
Yeah.
And I was on the State of Tennessee Hall of Fame board.
Oh, okay.
And they didn't have a category for the team.
Basketball. And this, of course, is none other. None other than Dr. Richard Dick Skull Barnett. I want to make sure that what we do is get you to the promised land. The promised land is you're here now at Tennessee State. We want to put this package together because we think that you all are deserving of to be recognized at the White House by in doing this administration during the Biden and Harris administration. But we need to package that well so that they can see what excellence really is. And starting back in 1957, 58, 59, when they played under the NAIA league that was not recognized by the NCAA. So now that we have worked, so for all these years, Dick needed to tell the story when they told him that he was not smart enough to do anything else in life. He got hurt after having a stint with the Lakers, played with Jerry West, got a chance to meet him, but also playing with the Knickerbockers. So playing with the Knicks, he got hurt. And what did he do? Go back to college and became, not only got his degree, he became a PhD. George went and taught school for 37 years in LA after he had his playing stint. So we didn't produce just athletes and they went to pasture. They actually graduated and went on and had led productive lives. That's the first class. So this package, what we have to do is make sure that's not it. Not only once we get you all the Medal of Freedom, whatever that medal is that we need to get you at the White House, we want to make sure that this exhibit on this basketball team is in the Smithsonian, the African American Museum. So with some of you know that we had our exhibit in 2015, working in 2015 and 16 when they opened. I had the great pleasure, the president gave me that assignment to get us in the museum, and we got it in there, and we have two exhibits in there about Wilma Rudolph and the Tiger Bells and Ed Temple. So we're very proud of that. So what other way that we can make sure that we cement our place in history by none other than these two legendary people? So I want to personally take a point of privilege to thank President Glover for just moving forward with this, but also to AD Allen. We have another Allen, we call him VP. So AD Allen, for he allowing us to bring you guys in, celebrating it on this weekend, and didn't help
to find it. So good. That's a Barnett. I mean, whenever I see your number flash over my office, what I'm going, I gotta go. It's that's a Barnett, Dick Barnett on the phone. They said, who else? I'll tell you later, you might hang up. You might miss the call. So we've been working, just trying quietly, and not so quietly, trying to get things in Washington. It's just so much is going on, and so many things always jump in front of us. But we're working on it. So Brett and I have been working on it. I had a chance to mention it to her, to the vice president at her Christmas party. But I didn't have much time to talk to her, but I had a little time, we mentioned it. She said, I think I know about her, send me something on it. So I did, so I haven't heard anything back, so. So Grant was putting something together, formally. I just sent a pair, don't forget. But anyway.
Two, three. Got two of that. I'll get one, I'll send them to you, Dr. Glover. Let me get one with this camera, and then I'm gonna.
Oh.
Dick Barnett, right here. All right.
I want to see if I can get a picture with Mr. Barnett.
Oh, sure, absolutely.
How you doing, sir?
This is our former
thank you.
State Senate right there.
We were trying to get him know, they would let us know.
Yeah, so why don't you turn him around? Is that right? Because you grew up in Chattanooga.
Right.
That's right. So they brought you up here.
Every time I come up here in the summer, they give me a summer job. They made sure I would come to Tennessee State.
Well, you're a long way away from Chattanooga now. L.A. treated you right, didn't
it?
Man, that was an opportunity to be in L.A. When you got drafted, you decided to play for the ABA
McLendon came from the ABA. Right. And
but
he was paying more money in the ABA than the NBA.
That's what happened.
And he drafted, there were five ball players on Tennessee State team. And they won the championship there too. They were complaining about how could you draft five ball players off of one school?
That was talent, wasn't it?
Barnhill, Barnett, and I was over there, they traded me to Los Angeles.
You've been there
ever since. They left five of them there. And McLendon won the championship.
That's walking.
Barnett from the NBA.
So there you have it.
62 Cleveland Pipers.
Right.
That's right. So there you have it, folks. There you have it, folks. These are walking history makers. These are walking legends. This is what legendary looks like.
I played NBA 2K22.
Yeah.
You know, I've been using his jump shot. His jump shot like this.
Yep.
Yeah. He made me make my shots for real.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Dick, so much. You made me win games in 2K.
Okay.
So your handshake?
What's that? Oh, okay. Fantastic. Okay. Good to meet you.
Yeah. I don't think anybody's ever been able to do that jump shot like Dick. I think it's his signature, and nobody will ever do it the same way.
There's only one Dick Barnett.
That's right, and he's here. And this is the gym where they made, as well as baseball, this incredible history. This team, it was the first team for 3 years in a row to win national championships back to back.
Because I wanted to see the last thing you cut because I knew you had a good man and you pick up stuff for
you. I bought it so you
can
see Ben on it.
Yeah, definitely. What are you talking about? Art Gowen?
You know Ben?
No, that's not.
Southpaw shooting star for Tennessee.
My students call me Dr. Barnett. I've even been called names that I'd rather not repeat. But I call myself the Dream Whisperer because everything starts with a dream.
Hi, I'm Reverend Al Sharpton. I am excited about the Dream Whisperer at Tennessee State. What it meant, what it means, for the nation, for the country, what Dick Barnett has done. And the way that it has been embraced by Dr. Glenda Glover, the incomparable, in my opinion, academician president in this country, be involved in not only watching Dream Whisperer, but spreading the word. It is not only our history, it's our culture, it's our progress. Dream Whisperer, I'm proud to have been a part of it.
We laid the ground. This is before Dr. King emerged on the scene. 5 years before the Public Accommodation Bill, Tennessee State students were picketing and fighting back in the best tradition of our people. says to you, my friends, we look at Tennessee State. It's a place where God has a special blessing. School of a rare Boston attendant, Olympic gold medalist, Wilma Rudolph, Olympic gold medalist, and triumphed over so many obstacles. School of Barnett and the team led by Coach McLendon, three national championships in a row, in succession, like back to back to back to back. And they got not only played basketball, they also graduated. Scholars, a PhD in education, for example. We never stopped fighting back, Dr. Glover. So Barnett, you represent something very special to us. Very special to us. They would have a media star on television every night who shoots excellent points. You shot a lot of points every night. Before Magic Johnson was Magic, you were shooting that ball. It was definitely left hand Charlie O. Thank you, man. But not only shining out walls, but building bridges. You alone helped to power the whole Tennessee State University to fight for dignity over dollars. You made a principal commitment to social justice, racial justice, and peace. Oh yeah, this film should be seen at the White House. Matter of fact, your house and my house will really make a difference. We should have a screening that appreciate black talent.